You. Okay. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for this nice conference. Today I would like to talk about geometric inequalities on submanifolds in Riemannian manifolds. Let me start with classical isoperimetric inequality before. Classical isoperimetric inequalities tells us that if you have a compact domain D in Euclidean space, then we have this inequality. Here, volume of D means n-dimensional volume of D, and volume of boundary D means that the volume of the n minus one dimensional volume of boundary of D. So, and this inequality holds this equality holds if and only if D is a ball. We want to generalize this inequality in two elementary ways. One is generalize the ambient space Rn into more general Riemannian manifold, and another one is to generalize domain. It means that in this case we have a domain, but we can generalize this case to higher codimensional cases. So, in this way, there is a very well-known geometric inequality. If you have a n-dimensional compact submanifold in M in Euclidean space, then we have this kind of inequality. Here, H means mean curvature of M in Euclidean space.
N is the dimension of M.
Yeah, right. N is the dimension of M. And compared to this inequality, we have an additional term. Additional term here. So it's a little bit different. The nice thing about this inequality is we can say more general inequality for submanifolds, general submanifolds. But we don't know the bad thing is we don't know the equality case in this case.
Embedded submanifold, embedded.
We don't need embeddedness. Yes. Yes. Okay. So, it is very well known that there is a corresponding Sobolev inequality related to this inequality here. Okay. So, I want to introduce different type of inequalities. Here we have a non-trivial power of volume of M, but we have another different isoperimetric inequality. If you have a domain n-dimensional domain sigma in hyperbolic space, or if you have a n-dimensional minimal submanifold sigma of hyperbolic space HM, then we have this kind of isoperimetric inequality. This inequality called linear isoperimetric inequality because we don't have the additional power here. So this is called linear isoperimetric inequality. So we can generalize this inequality as follows. Here, we generalize domain sigma into n-dimensional compact submanifold sigma, and ambient space can be generalized complete, simply connected Riemannian manifold with sectional curvature bounded above by negative curvature, constant curvature. So, as before, we have additional term, a mean curvature term here. In particular, if you have a if sigma has a mean curvature zero, then it's exactly the same inequality. Okay, in order to prove this linear isoparametric inequality, we shall prove the corresponding Sobolev inequality. The condition is the same as before. Okay. To prove this Sobolev inequality, the first step is to use Laplace comparison of extrinsic distance function. For extrinsic distance function r, we have a Laplace comparison as follows. Laplace r is greater than or equal to this term. Here we have a mean curvature term. And second step is to use to multiply a test function and take a divergence. Multiply f and take divergence, then we have this equality, and then we use the first step. So we have this inequality, and then we estimate the simple observation. We have simple observation here. Final step is integrate over sigma, and then use divergence theorem. Then we have the corresponding isoparametric inequality. In particular, if dimension is 2, then we can say much more things. Professor Choi proved that if sigma is a compact minimal surface in a complete simply connected Riemannian manifold with sectional curvature bounded above by a constant k, then this isoparametric inequality holds. But in this case, the isoparametric constant is 2 pi, not 4 pi, is a weaker isoparametric inequality. Here we have a curvature additional term of curvature k. If the curvature bound is positive, then we assume the diameter is less than or equal to pi over 2 square root of k.
What's the equality
hope? We don't know the equality case. Actually, the conjecture is to prove that 4 pi in the inequality, the conjecture is true. This inequality is true for the constant 4 pi. If we consider,
k is zero, so that's weak.
Yes, right, right. If sigma has a bounded mean curvature, in complete simply connected Riemannian manifold M with sectional curvature bounded above by a positive constant K, then we have this similar isoparametric inequality, but it's quite complicated. When H is equal to zero, then it's a little bit different inequality here. In order to prove the isoparametric inequality, we also prove the corresponding Sobolev inequality. We also have a different result as follows. One is this inequality, and the other one is this inequality. Here, we have an additional term here. And this constant is greater than 1, as you know. So, but it's a kind of generalization of Jae-kyung-Choi's result here. He considered a compact minimal surface case, but this result can be generalized for compact surface sigma with bounded mean curvature. Okay, next topic is first eigenvalue estimate. The definition of first eigenvalue of a Riemannian manifold with boundary is characterized as the Rayleigh quotient, like this. Here, the infimum is taken over all compactly supported smooth function f on sigma. One basic result is proved by Chung and Long. They proved that if M is complete minimal submanifold in hyperbolic space, then first eigenvalue has a lower bound m-1 squared divided by 4. This result is sharp because the equality holds M is totally geodesic. It is proved by McKean. In this case, first eigenvalue has lower bound. The next question is, are there some upper bound on first eigenvalue? So, Kendall proved that for specific sigma, it has upper bound 4/3. In this case, sigma is a complete simply connected stable minimal surface in three-dimensional hyperbolic space. There are two conditions. One is simply connectedness, another one is stability. We remark that stability of minimal hypersurfaces can be characterized as follows. We call M is stable if the second variation of the area functional is non-negative. Yeah, then we call such manifold is stable. We want to generalize this first this inequality for first eigenvalue. So we consider three-dimensional simply connected Riemannian manifold with the pinched curvature has k constant k, sectional curvature k has a negatively finished curvature, then first eigenvalue of sigma satisfies these inequalities. Another generalization is like this. If we consider M complete stable minimal hypersurface in hyperbolic space with the L2 norm of second fundamental form is finite, then we have similar upper bound of first eigenvalue. Okay. Next theorem is about the first eigenvalue, lower bound of first eigenvalue. In this case, we have additional condition here. If sigma is contained in a geodesic ball of radius r, then we can say this inequality. Okay, in order to prove this inequality, first we choose the test function f square, multiply f square to gradient r, and then take divergence. Then we have we use Laplacian comparison here, and then we obtain this inequality. And next, integrate both sides over sigma, then we have this inequality, and we use Cauchy-Schwarz inequality here for any epsilon, positive epsilon, then we have this inequality. Here, epsilon is chosen later. So this inequality holds for any positive epsilon. So we maximize the quadratic function. In this case, first eigenvalue is the infimum of this quotient. So, but in the left-hand side doesn't depend on function f. So we can maximize this left-hand side. Then we obtain the lower bound of first eigenvalue. The quadratic function on sigma epsilon. So we can obtain this inequality here. This eigenvalue estimate can be generalized to this case. If sigma is an n-dimensional submanifold in a complete simply connected Riemannian manifold M with sectional curvature bounded above by a negative constant k, and h denotes the mean curvature of sigma, and we assume the mean curvature is bound, the length of mean curvature is bounded, then we have this first eigenvalue estimate. In particular, if sigma is minimal, then alpha is equal to zero, then it is obtained by Chung and Long, as before I mentioned. Yeah, okay. Thank you for your attention.
Are there any questions?